boxy rides hit the market a few years ago, the Kia Soul turned out to be the surprise home run. They sell as many of these things as twice the XB and the Cube combined. So when you go to refresh this car, you don't screw around. Let's take a look at the 2014 Kia Soul. Now, the main headline on how they've laid this car out is not so much in a change of the overall look. It still looks like a Soul to my eye, but the dimensions are quite different around the wheels. There's another inch this way, that's the wheelbase, but 6 more inches this way, that's the track, and that gives this guy a much more planted, less tippy look, which, if anything polarized folks negatively about it, that was it. They seem to have really cured that. Now, inside, a big difference in the cabin quality of the new Soul. It used to be pretty Spartan and squared off in here. Look at this, all organic shapes now, whether you like that or not. I think it looks a lot better. Lots of soft materials with a better kind of a quality to them and a completely different look, dominated by this big boy, an optional 8-inch LCD. In here, you can have Yuvo e-services. That's their connected platform that, among other things, lets you flick through things like a smartphone and kind of toss the screen up and down, as opposed to those clunky page-up, page-down interfaces you normally see in cars. On that screen, of course, could be optional navigation. I see here it's going to be SD card-based. Also, I think it's a first for Kia, at least for the Soul, Pandora integration in there as well, so you can control your Pandora stream from your phone here, put the phone aside. And top trim models have another LCD screen, an enlarged LCD between the gauges to give you helper display stuff like just the latest nav instruction or currently what you're listening to on the media. So this car is definitely going upscale if you load it up. Another thing I've noticed, and a lot of you ask about this, how's the room? You know, I'm pretty tall, 6'2". I am in driving position right now, and I'm looking back and I see quite reasonable back seat leg room. I could sit behind me in this car, just FYI. They also have put a bigger hatchback here, which was another gripe about the Soul. Now you can get into what space it has more readily. That goes with that additionally spacious back seat. Up front, the engines are not bigger, but they're very high tech. A 1.6 or a 2-liter direct injection gasoline 4. Now, pricing and availability on this car are still somewhat up in the air. Third quarter in showrooms, they'll nail the price down as they get closer to that.